Hello everybody, welcome back to XCOM 2. So we are proceeding apace. The next objective that we've got is to construct the Shadow Chamber, but we don't have any cash for that at the moment. We don't have any cash for anything, and we have plenty of stuff to spend it on too. So let's just take a look and see where we're going next. Avatar Project is down by one because we killed the first Codex.
For their resilience in defeating this creature, Commander. The aliens will be left scrambling to recover from this setback.
Excellent. There's an abandoned camp there that could get some intel. That's pretty good. It's probably more useful than that soldier as well. Although we do have making contact there for one day to deal with. You know what? We're going to do it anyway. We're going to head over here.
Setting course.
Finish that.
Eastern
finish the soldier.
European ward.
We might as well get the free soldier. We spent 3 days on it. And then we'll probably hop back for the intel. I should imagine. This will also allow us to get lock and load. The European bonus. What's up, guys? Why is one of you Quicksilver? Okay.
Signal's coming through clear.
Got a new income, which is great.
Contacts located.
Astasia is the one we want, because that's the one with a black sight. Personal combat sims and weapon upgrades may be reused, which is good. Not insanely good, but good nevertheless. So we have... We're not going to do anything.
Avenger,
we're
going to
go grab the soldier, we're going to go grab that intel, and then we'll decide what we'll do. But we're not in any great deep rush for anything right now. I'd love to get contact with there and take that black site out, but yeah, it's not a massive priority right now.
I have made a number of interesting discoveries, Commander.
We've researched the storm gun, which is the endgame version of the shotgun. With the inherent difficulties in trying to forge or manipulate the alien alloys we've recovered from the field, our thought process as to how this material could be used to our advantage turned towards some of our more traditional, rudimentary weapon designs. In containing a small cluster of alloy fragments within a highly energized magnetic field, we found it is possible to discharge the cluster using a plasma pulse of varying intensity. The overall design is akin to that of a shotgun, although the result comes more from our inability to form proper projectiles than it does from our desire to generate this particular outcome. Having seen firsthand some of the recent alien forces our troops have been dealing with, I have no doubts they'll still find this new design appealing for its overall stopping power. Absolutely. We still need to research that. We're going to leave these autopsies where they are for now. I guess we'll take the beam cannon. Or the plasma lance. We'll take the one that's less days.
I'll see that work begins immediately, Commander.
We're running ahead with the science, but we don't have the money to take full advantage of it at the moment. But, that's just how it is. Let's get an extra soldier. Lieutenant Grenadier, that's pretty good news. That's someone we needed at the moment. Is an extra Grenadier after losing Marie. And that person's quite a bit better than Marie as well.
Don't tell her
or her grieving family. Okay, let's go get this intel. And then we'll probably maybe open up. You're still getting that intel pop. And is it actually popping? It is, isn't it? That's a bit weird. I'm not going to turn it down. Dark Event complete. New construction. They step up their construction efforts, reducing the alien facility count by 2 weeks.
Commander,
that's actually all right.
One of their facilities.
Okay, where is that? It's there. Okay. There we go. That's fine. I don't know why I can't contact them from down here. Apparently I can only contact them from there. Maybe it's different in every game? I don't know. Regardless, that's blatantly the first black site we're going to go after, so...
Strategic resource located.
Got a bit of intel. Now the question is, how much is that going to cost us? 100 supplies. We can't do that. We literally cannot do that. At the moment. So do we wait... to install this, or do we just make contact here first? I think we probably just make contact here. I think that's probably the wisest thing to do, because it's going to take 6 days for another supply drop. Yeah, 60 intel, whatever.
Commander,
we've got 120.
All of our available communications capacity. We can't establish any new contacts until we upgrade our systems.
That's fine. This should take, what, 4 days? Yeah, so we'll get more supplies in our supply drop, which is nice.
Attempting to establish local regional
blue screen
contact.
Protocol, development completed. Let's take a look. I think we've got another one lined up. New item available, EMP grenade and blue screen rounds, both of which do extra damage to robotic enemies. But I think we've got, yeah, we've got an experimental grenade lined up anyway, so we'll just let them carry on with that. If we take a peek in the armory. We've got Sea Breeze, Svetlana Pavlova. Okay, well, Marie was the one we lost, and she's mixed, right? Because Pyros are kind of explosive expert, and Claymore is our gunner. So Sea Breeze will be mixed, I believe. So let's take a look at what we can do with that. So would I rather have blast padding for an extra point of armor, or Shredder? I'd definitely rather have Shredder. Would I rather have demolition or suppression? Demolition, without it being a guaranteed hit, isn't that good, I think. So I'm going to take suppression there. And then hollow targeting. Increase squads aimed by plus 15 or heavy ordnance. I'd actually rather have heavy ordnance, I think. Hollow targeting is good, don't get me wrong, but that's just an extra attack. An extra grenade. I do like an extra grenade. So that's good. Okay. I would like
New
to
orders,
go
Commander?
Check how much the built stuff is going to cost me. So blue screen rounds is only 75 supplies. Again, we can't have it at the moment, but you know, at least it's not going to be pricey when it does come to the table. Storm guns, beam pistols, plasma rifles, all pricey stuff. All pricey stuff. Although storm guns are a lot cheaper than plasma rifles. Warden armor as well. All this stuff has to wait for a supply drop, because we're just not going to have the cash for it, anywhere near the cash for it, until we get that in play. So, supply raid. Okay, Operation Iron Mother. Raid the Advent Convoy.
Setting
Don't mind if I do.
Eastern United States.
This should get us some tasty supplies of various kinds. Some Illyrium and bits and pieces all around. Let me drop everyone and start again, as is my preference. Let's make everything available. So, who we've taken along? You know what? You know who we haven't taken along for a while is Priestess. And I've got a reason I want to take Priestess, but we'll cover that later. We'll take Priestess and Rizzo. We will take Pale Rider, because, you know, it's good to have you back. We will take our new Grenadier, Seabreeze. We will take Jessica. And that leaves us needing a assault soldier, ranger, I should say. We've already got two mages in there, so, you know, I'm going to take Ice. I know he's had a few trips out recently, but it's fine. As for Seabreeze, well, for a start, you can take one of our fancier mag cannons. Made by 5%, clip size by plus 2. I do like, with the shredding, the aim might be a good idea. Yeah, we'll go for that. We'll go for that. You get a double flashbang, obviously. It's a good idea. And you know what? We didn't, I think we need to customize you a little bit. What can you get? You can have some, we've given you a red weapon, so let's give you red armor. Although, to be fair, Pyro also has red armor. But you can have red and red and blue. I can't remember what Pyro has. He might have red and blue as well. I don't think he does, so that's fine. You're twitchy. which is just fine by me. You know what? Let's give you something in the way of props. Yeah, okay. Let's give you not a monocle, that's ridiculous. You know what, you can take an eye patch. There you go. You're pretty cool with an eye patch. That'll do. That'll do for now. Seabreeze can have an eye patch, why not? As for everybody else, well now. Pale Rider, you can take... Why am I going into customize? I don't know. You can take... This one's probably better off for you, being as you won't fire it quite as much. You can take the battle scanner, which you probably won't end up using. I very rarely use it at all. Priestess. Well, now, for a start, again with the customize, for your loadout, there's two magnetic rifles on the field. You can take this one with the advanced hair trigger, why not? Now, you are taking the Skulljack. Reason being, if you get to hack in on an enemy troop, I want you to have a decent chance to actually get something out of their brain. So that's why I'm taking that. As for a red, which is the better magnetic rifle here? Probably that one. They're 5% chances, but they're good 5% chances. If they come off, I'll be very grateful for them. And then we've got Ice, who's going to take the usual stuff, really. He'll take the shard gun, because it's got two things on it. He'll also take... See, Nanoscale Vest or Mimic Beacon, because I'd rather have Psychic with... Yeah, you know, he's going to take the Mimic Beacon. Because I probably always want to use a psychic ability, so. And also, you got banged up last time, and I don't want my only psychic to take too much damage, so you're going to get the nanoscale vest. And I think that's everything. Ooh, hang on. Actually. I forgot about the exosuit. Which means no one's got the Mimic Beacon, but that's alright. I'd rather have... We're going to dump the Battle Scanner. I'm never that bothered by it. I know other people swear by them, especially in the first game, but... I'm just never that bothered by them. Oh, actually, we can give it to Seabreeze. It's fine. Oh, God. Why do I do this? Everyone should be loaded up with everything. Yep, that's fine. You know what? I know I shouldn't have done this. Can I not clear it? Can I not just clear these? That's annoying. No, that's fine. That'll do. It's fine. I'm not messing around with it for the sake of one thing. That is absolutely fine. This extra rocket launcher will be handy. I'm glad we remembered that. I think I gave everyone guns, correct guns. Yes, I think I did. I'm sure I'll find out if I didn't. Let's launch it. We're starting to get teams going out who definitely kind of look and feel more badass now. That I'm more confident about. I'm glad I now have enough utility items to actually fully load out my troops. And now that we've got the foundry in place, we should be able to get some nice experimental grenades and armor and various things that should help us even more, so. These things will be good.
One of our contacts in the Resistance tipped us to an advent transport they managed to disable when it passed through as part of a larger convoy. Advent security forces are already moving to gather their assets, but we've got a shot at finding something valuable here. We'll have to secure the area, recover the gear, and eliminate any enemy resistance.
Can do. Yeah, look at these guys. Far more confident. Nasty little devices in their pockets. That was a quick load. There was there have been a couple of patches recently because of the Alien Hunters DLC, but so maybe they've fixed the load time delay. That would be welcome.
Menace 1-5, the disabled Advent convoy is just ahead. Engage and eliminate all hostile forces.
Will do. Okay, so where have we got everyone? Where's Ice? Ice, there you are.
Moving.
That's a nice little position. And let's probably start moving some people down as well. Who's better off close up? Definitely our Grenadier.
Moving to designated coordinates.
Can I go over here? Yeah, there's no one over there. I can zip straight
over.
Orders
confirmed.
Here.
On the move.
Okay, as for Red, you know, I might as well just start moving people down and forwards. Because I don't think I'll be able to get many shots from up here, apart from the sniper, and Pale Rider's better not being a sniper, so...
Stepping off.
She might not even stay up here. As for Priestess, you know, follow up a little bit. Let's have a little bit of overwatch in. Oh no, we're concealed. There's no point in overwatch. But there's also only a limited amount of room around this tree, and I think someone could wander in here with a flank view, so that's fine. But as for Pale Rider, you know what? You can actually move a little bit up under on top here, because at the beginning of next turn, you could get a nice sniper shot off if...
Got it covered.
Affirmative on overwatch.
Nice. Glad that's working now. Come on, wander into my line of sight. Nasty red mech. It's a bit far away for us. Ice. Where can you go that's quite close with good line of sight? I'd love you to get up here instead. Because I'd like to rocket them, really. That's what I'd like. That's nice. That is nice. We need to move other people up first. That's the thing we need to do. There's a huge amount of great cover here. You... can safely move here, I think. And then Seabreeze can move up here.
Moving.
And then Prophet, you know what, you're not going to go into Overwatch, so you can just stay where you are right now.
Confirmed.
You can go up here. I'd love you to be able to get a hack in, but that's not very likely. Okay, where can we... Let's just have a quick look with the rocket launcher what we can do from here. Because we can get them there from here. We can lay it down by the look of it. Yep. So is there somewhere better than here? You know, I actually don't think there is. We could move closer. Just to be close for next time. That's, you know, there's something to be said for that. And here, we're not going to get flanked by. So you know what, we're going to do that. We're going to move over here.
Confirmed.
Now, let's lay down some overwatches. Definitely on red.
As they will.
Sea breeze, or we're going to stick with having a frag grenade. I think we might see what we can get from Seabreeze. We might just put down one set of Overwatch. I think that's fine. Okay. Rocket launcher the hell out of these guys, please. And with as little damage to the thing as possible. I don't know where the third guy is, but that'll do. Nice. Ooh. Only took one damage from that. That's a shame. And that miss is also a shame. Okay, let's get our sniping first. Well, we can lightning hands, actually. Yeah, that's worth it, because that could be a kill. And is. Excellent. Good start.
Solo il meglio.
You said it. Let's see what we can do with our shredder first. One could always launch a frag, which would catch them both. That's probably worth it. And we'll also shred.
Frag out.
And that's why we left Sea Breeze without Overwatch. Now, I'd really love to take that mech down. Can we move forward? If one thing is left, we can move forward in stasis. Which is, you know, a thing we want to happen. Who else we got left? Pale Rider, Prophet, Priestess. Okay, well, you're definitely taking the shard, the heavy mech. And I think we can do this via a number of... Oh, free action. Oh, well, there we go then. Because I think we could have combat protocols. Oh, no, can only do it on him. Okay, well, that could have been taking him out anyway, and then we could have stasis that guy, but I don't think we need to now. I think we can just... I think we can just get a kill here on Pale Rider. Well, quite. And then Priestess can either combat protocol that guy to death, or let's try and see if we can
sure thing.
Move Prophet in. If that shot like 76%. It's a shame to use up Null Lance, but you know what? I'm actually tempted to do this instead. We've got the backup, it's fine. I'm going to inspire ice.
The enemy should fear us.
Because A, if Prophet gets the kill, she doesn't get any XP for it. B, I'd rather save the combat protocol, so we can probably just kill him with an 88% shot. If not, we'll just combat protocol. That's fine. There we go. Nicely done.
Kill confirmed.
And you can just drop some of what.
Come get some.
There we go. That went well. What are we going to do over here? Where are the other troops is the question. We did set that on fire, which is unfortunate, but so it goes. Where are we going? Well, we need to play catch up a little bit. So let's just
good
go over
copy.
Here.
Moving on target.
We haven't got a time limit. There's no reason for us to rush. You are actually going to move up to... Well, let's see how everyone... Let's move everyone at the front first. I mean, that's the sensible thing to do, right?
Absolutely!
Come on, guys. There we go. Shall we move forward a little bit? Okay. Slightly risky. We're fine. And then Seabreeze can go to... again, we could make a slightly risky move of going to here. Let's go to here. At least that's in full cover.
I guess that'll be okay.
We've still got a load of shots. It's fine. It's all fine. It's all fine. It's all gravy. Okay, with Priestess, we're going to go... We can go over here.
Getting it done.
That should be fine. And then with Pale Rider, we're just going to dash up to here.
Okay, mi muovo.
And drop a load of Overwatch.
Got it covered.
Affirmative, covering now.
You can have a reload instead. Don't need Overwatch on everyone.
Pronto sparare.
Okay. Ice is going to take a... Nothing going to blow up. It doesn't look to be on fire. The fire could spread, but...
Confirmed. Right.
Okay. Got an Archon. Got a Sectoid. Two Sectoids. Bunch of Vipers as well, unfortunately. Okay. Well, this could be better. Definitely could be better. So what have we got? If I trigger face off, I'm only going to hit them. So essentially I'm... I could move forward and trigger face off, but there's not much great cover. He's, however, a nice sniping shot. For a 93% on that sectoid. I have to max my damage. Okay, what can we do with explosives? Not much is the answer. We can pop down a flashbang, which is nice. We can pop down a stasis, which is also nice. What kind of null lance can I get from here? Or more likely from here. Because we're flanked there, so I don't want that. This is not the place I wanted them to spawn, for sure. As for ice, you're going to have to run and gun. Definitely going to have to run and gun. It's either that or move backwards out of cover. And I don't really want to retreat, so... we get a flank shot from there on him. You know, I'm going to take it. Or I could... I can grenade. And that's not a bad idea. Come on, I must be able to get those two. Yes, I can. Choices. You've got the Mimic Beacon, and the Mimic Beacon might actually be quite handy in this scenario. This is actually quite a tricky one. How far can that flashbang go from here? You need a little bit of movement forward, but not all the movement forward. But I'd love this spot for red rather than sea breeze, but I don't think it's possible. I'm going to have to move you forward and see what you can do.
On my way.
Further forward. As for Priestess... Yeah, I think I'm going to have to do this. You're going to move
Hitting
over
out.
Here. Not a lot of great cover, I have to confess. And red, you're going to have to go here.
Per me va bene.
And Seabreeze can go here.
I'm trusting you here.
Oh god, you've got that voice pattern. I'm almost certainly going to flashbang you, but... Right, so what can we do? We can put anyone in stasis, which is great. We can also try out insanity, but I'd rather do that at a point where we are less in trouble. Can I get both of them with a null lance? 7 to 12 damage. Not quite. I think if I null lance here, I'll unfortunately also get ice in it. I'm mildly surprised I can't get both of these guys. Because it tracks just a little less distance away. Unless I can somehow... No, unfortunately not. So that's probably going to be a stasis rather than a null lance. Unless I can get a guaranteed kill with a null lance after everyone else has done their stuff. But regardless, Ice, you're going to take Are you going to take that? The thing is, I might need the mimic beacon on Pale Rider, which is why I don't want that 100% shot. 5%, 40%, not great. The aid protocol might be handy. What about Priestess? Again, not great shots. Ugh, this is rough. I'm gonna have to take this attack, I think. Okay, well that's good. That is good.
Good riddance.
Quite.
Got something over here.
We're definitely gonna mimic beacon this now. In which case, what am I gonna do with my other guys? Well, what I am gonna do, I'm definitely gonna flashbang everyone here. It would be stupid of me not to.
Grenade out!
Okay, and now we are going to... You know what? We're going to take a... We've got the Mimic Beacon dropping, so we're going to take a slight risk. We could Null Lance. Stasising someone with a Mimic Beacon down is a bit pointless. We're actually going to Insanity on the Viper closest to us. Why not?
Reality is fleeting.
Because the Mimic Beacon should save our skins for the most part. Mind controlled! Hurrah! Okay. Well, that's goodness. But I don't think I get them this turn, do I? No, I don't. Okay. So Pale Rider can fling a Mimic Beacon over. Over here. And then now, how about Priestess? What's Priestess going to get up to? I'm thinking Overwatch might be the best thing. Because this guy's got to move out here. The others are probably going to advance. What's your Overwatch stuff? You have got covering fire, so you're definitely going to go into Overwatch. But Priestess, maybe not. Maybe we'll go for a shot on the Archon. Although that is our 52, and if it moves... See, if it moves, we can see it already, so that means we won't get the help from it being closer because it'll trigger straight away. Yeah, we'll take a shot at it. Why not? Nope.
Not good.
But we're alright, we've got one of the mind controls. We've got a mimic beacon. We're pretty good. We're doing alright. Nice. Well done, Red. Phew. Ooh, that was painful. Hopefully it can take two more shots. Two more disoriented shots at that. That's one more. It's still up by the look of it. Fine. That's absolutely fine. And we now have control of the Viper. Which suits me down to the ground. Okay, so what are we going to do? Well, let's see what we can do with this Viper first, shall we? Can we do a tongue grab? No tongue pull? Because it can only be done on my troops, maybe. I don't know. I can get a nice flank on a number of things. On either the sectoid or... a number of things. I don't have any cover to advance to, so I'm probably stuck with... a good old snipe shot here. 74% on the Archon. going to go for that. Nice. Very nice. So, Ice. How are you doing, mate? Could do a melee attack. Could advance to here and just absolutely waste that sectoid. That's not a bad notion.
On my way.
Hopefully not open up another pod. And we'll also grab that loot. Two Illyrium cores.
Got
nothing to be
here.
Sniffed at. Hello. Oh, didn't kill them. Interesting.
I'm running low on ammo.
Sea breeze. Again, nowhere to really move to. Maybe here to open up this. Someone else? I don't know. It's easily flanked, though. That's the problem. And I don't want to open up another pod or something. It's a good question, actually. Maybe one for another time. Prophet, what are you going to do? Well, I think I've answered what this Viper is going to do, because that's only one damage. What's their weapon? Oh, 3 to 5. Okay. Well, you ain't killing that Viper. In which case, I'm going to use you to kill this sectoid. Hello. Only 75%. That's rubbish. Got it, though. Shame to lose the XP, but that's what mind control's for. Well, not for losing XP. You, my friend, are going to go... We've got to kill this Archon, really. But there's a number of ways we can do that. And one of them is to move up with Priestess. Not that we need to move up with Priestess, but moving up in general is a good idea. And we can combat protocol it to death, I think. We can do 4 damage, and then we can stasis the Viper, because we don't have many other people to do many other things. There's no cover to move to here, so I might just take the shot of the Archon to try and not use up my combat protocol. And I might also... That's not in cover, right? So I could move up. I think we're all right here. I think we can profit. Can you... You can stasis both these things. Okay, so we just need to kill that Archon. And I think we can guaranteed kill it if we want. But if we might as well not use up our combat protocol if we don't have to. So I think we're okay being out in the open is ultimately what I mean. Well, that Viper could come out of mind control at any moment. Oh, and we shot it. We shot it because we weren't paying attention to what we were doing. Hell, well, we needed to deal with it at some point anyway. That's fine. I think we're still okay. Red, you move here. And take a shot at that Archon. I have done that a few times before. It's irritating when it happens. Well, the Archon's out of there, and we're just going to stasis that Viper. Gonna move up.
Not a problem.
Stasis the Viper.
I'm very protective.
And that's about it, really. Apart from probably move Priestess up. Just get some forward motion.
Sure thing.
Yep. Hello.
That is 1-5. Watch those supply crates. If you destroy them, there won't be anything left for us to recover once the area is secure. Heading there now.
Yeah, you are. Okay. Well, you might as well try and slash it to death. Right. Stunned for two? Does that mean it's not dead? I'm pretty sure it's dead. Oh no, it's not dead. Interesting. Stunned for two though, so that's fine. Prophet, you go here.
Absolutely.
Someone else is just going to bang away a shot on it. Well, I'd rather not have you kill it, to be honest. You know what I'm going to do? Well, why use the Inspire if I don't have to? That's, you know, fundamentally a thing.
On my way.
What accent is that? That's ludicrous. Might as well take a shot. Try and get some... There we go. Get some XP on Priestess, that's fine. Should have one or two more pods.
Ce la posso fare.
What's over there?
And Pale Rider, you can run all the way forward because we're not using your pistols properly by having you back here. You've still been handy, don't get me wrong, but
I'm on it.
Not moving any further forward than this.
Moving to Overwatch.
You can grab a reload.
Sono di nuovo pronto.
Okay. What we're doing over here is a valuable question.
Orders confirmed. On the move.
Okay.
Advent troops here.
They're all on this side. Interesting. Got a shield bearer there. Be handy to take him out, but not sure how much I can do about that. Anyway. I thought I had a free reload. I don't. That's irritating. Prophet, what can you do? Is there a null lance you can drop? Not quite, but maybe if you move up, I don't know. Maybe if you move up. You're in full cover there though, which is nice. Then you also can't do anything particularly with it. So, I don't know. You could inspire Pale Rider, and therefore we get a... let's see what other people can do when they move up. So, Priestess. We're going to have to resign ourselves to this shield bearer getting the shield down.
Not a problem.
What are we like here? Great. What are we like with a frag grenade? Can't hit more than one. Got a decent shot there, but going to take a hit from it if we... Yeah, this isn't ideal. If we move... We've only got half cover here anyway. So if we move... We have full cover there, though. But then we won't be able to take any kind of shot. Well, we're not even close enough there for a... Gonna have to reload. Yeah, we're gonna take some damage here, I think. Know what to do in this scenario. It's rather tricksy. As for Seabreeze, I'm actually going to pop you here.
I'm trusting you here.
And then you're going to drop a flashbang on them. Can we get all of them? Not quite, but we can get the We can get the shield bearer, that's the important one. Can we get that guy? No. That's fine. Shield bearer is the important one, probably. Oh, I think I determined they can actually drop their shields when disoriented. I'm not entirely sure, to be honest. Either way. We're probably not killing any of them this turn, so a flashbang is good no matter what. And then red, you can go here.
Bado.
And you get your overwatch even if you you dash, so. Yeah, I think we're gonna have to
on
go
my
up
way.
Here. Null Lance there, like, can actually hit both of them, but also ice. Ice still has a move. Who does still have moves? Priestess, ice, red. You're gonna go here and get your overwatch.
Nessun problema, capo.
Priestess, ice, prophet. Ugh, because that null lance, unfortunately, also hits ice. But can ice do 7 to 12 damage anyway, is a good question. Not guaranteed. So it's actually worth him ducking away, I think. And also getting out of melee range for that Archon.
Moving out.
Okay. Null Lance the hell out of these guys.
I pierce all.
Yeah, you do. Oh, nice. It killed the shield bearer. Excellent. Okay, well, that's good. That's saved us quite a bit of hassle. Your combat protocol won't be enough for that, will it? No, it's 4. So I don't think Archons are robotic damage, so... what's your shot against it? 56. With a chance to kill. But if it moves forward... This is the thing, I don't know how far it moving forward and not being in cover. Because it's not in cover, I think I'm better off just taking the shot. Like, my shot's not going to get much better than that with Overwatch. And it's dead. So I'm very much glad I did.
What did you expect?
Running I don't know what I expected, Priestess. But you have... Ooh, hair trigger, free action, and a promotion earned. So, you know what? We're going to drop you into Overwatch.
We've
gotten some nice Overwatch racked up, actually. Because of our lots of moves. Like, full moves in Overwatch. I can't remember what the skill's called. Just into Overwatcher. Have we got an Overwatch runner? I think Ice is an Overwatch runner. Shadow Step, the soldier does not trigger Overwatch or return fire. Yep. Can we just... We could use Run and Gun instead, which is probably more of a guarantee. I don't know. But he's a Blade Master. Fuck it. I think we've got Stasis back. I don't think we're in trouble. Fuck your Overwatch, buddy. Overwatch removed. No shit!
Target neutralized.
I think that's probably it. Yep.
All hostiles are down and
well, that was a flawless mission. No damage.
Mission accomplished.
Couple of promotions earned. I'll take it. I'll definitely take it. Flawless. And we were in a couple of sticky positions there, so we were a bit lucky. But mostly, I'm awesome. I think that's what we can take from that. Ice doing a great job there. Putting the lie to my consideration that Rangers are the weakest class. Most under fire, Mimic Beacon. That's exactly what you want. 89% successful shot percentage, that's decent. Yeah. Pretty good, especially considering we didn't take that much heavy cover. So we're pretty lucky. I don't think any of our soldiers came under fire, though. I think it was entirely the Mimic Beacon, because we just managed to lock everyone down or get lucky with attacks or various and sundry. But I think we did well. We certainly didn't do badly. Come on, get back so I can give you the promotions you so richly deserve. The other good thing about not taking any wounds, particularly on the psychics at the moment, is it means their training isn't interrupted, which means they can just get better and better and better. I do need to actually get another psychic being trained. You can upgrade the psychic lab to take another trainee, which is very expensive but very worth it. Because otherwise I have to take Jessica out of training, which isn't ideal. Is not ideal. We blew up a few more crates than I would have liked for one of these convoy raids.
Still wondering what hit him. Let's keep it up, Commander.
Hell yes. So, Priestess, you've got a promotion. Which is threat assessment. Aid protocol now grants the target a covering fire overwatch shot, but the cooldown is increased by one turn. That's fine, though. And as for Ice, he gets Blade Storm. Free sword attacks on any enemies that enter or attack from melee range. So basically, he gets a counter like the mutons have. A little less fearsome, I think. But it's still good. If people come up to him, he gets to swipe away at them. Very useful against chrysalids. If you remember them from XCOM 1, trust me, they're coming. Oh, they are coming. A bunch of Illyrium cores. Corpses. 138 supplies. That's great. Illyrium crystals, alien alloys. Great stuff all around. Very handy. Resistance comms at capacity. Yeah, we got to remember that. So we've got to probably either expand this comms or build another comms in order to further our work. But we'll do one of those things at some point in the next couple of episodes. Speaking of which, this one's at an end. So thank you for watching. Please do leave a like, a comment, or a subscribe.
You know,
and they always stop talking.
I probably wouldn't be alive today if it weren't for your father.
When I'm about to win the episode.
Something of a miracle worker.
Getting the Avengers' power back online was a miracle. I'm not entirely sure how he deciphered their system, but we'd still be half buried in the sand if he hadn't. He gave everything he had to get the ship running. But he didn't live long enough to see her fly.
We owe you both a debt of gratitude.
You can honor his memory by using this ship to destroy the aliens wherever we find them.
You'll get no argument here.
Just honor his memory by killing things. Yes, lovely. Video games. So, thanks for watching, and I'll see you next time from XCOM 2. Goodbye.